All right, so let's take a look right here. This is radian measure because it has pi in it. So what you're going to do is just multiply by the conversion, which is 180 over pi. And you must memorize that. They're not going to give it to you. And the whole purpose of that is you want pi to cancel out. So now you're going to take 5 times that and then divide by 6. So it's going to be 5 times... Let me see if this one will work. So it's going to be 180 times 5 equals, and then divide by 6. I get 150 degrees. Any questions on how to make that conversion? Okay, it's not hard, but you got to memorize that. All right, the next one is the same way. So let me just see what 3 pi is. From here to here is 1 pi. From here to here is 2 pi. So a whole circle is 360. Okay? And then I want 3 pi. So 3 pi has got to be over to here. So it's got to be 360 plus 180. And that looks like 540, if I had to say. So let's see if this gives me 540. So I'm going to take 3 pi, and I'm going to multiply by 180 over pi. Bless you. Pi's cancel, so I get 3 180s, which I think is 540. So 3 times 180 equals 540. Is everybody clear on what I did? I did it two ways. I did it one way knowing that circle that I gave you. And in Algebra 2, they're going to call it the unit circle. Anyway, let's go on. The next one, it says, find the arc length and the area. This was like your worksheet yesterday, which I'm going to give you credit for today. So here we go. So the arc length is going to be 300 over 360 is my fraction. Both of them are going to be, so I'm going to write it twice. This one is going to be pi times diameter. This one's going to be pi radius squared. That's it. It's really not hard stuff. It's pretty easy. All right, so if you understood what I said, then you're going to substitute 3.14 right here. And the diameter is not 7, but it's 7 plus 7, so it's 14. The last thing you're going to do is divide. So clear your calculator out if you haven't done it. So it's going to be 300 times 3.14 times 14. Press equals, divide by 360. I get, let me see if I can change it on this thing. It gives it to me as a fraction. So I have 1099 divided by 30, and I'm not sure how to convert it. Does anybody know the answer on that? 36 point what? Okay. 36.6, and that would be inches. Okay, on the next one, you're going to do pi, which is 3.14. You're going to multiply by the radius squared, so 7 times 7. So it's going to be 49 times 3.14 times 300. Press equals, divide it by 360. And this one is a real large one, 7693 divided by 60. And what do you have, Lenora? 128.2 square inches. Any questions on how to do this work here? Is everybody clear? It's really pretty simple. I think this is like the easiest stuff you've seen. Okay, we talked about retest and homework. I do want the bell work, so let's do that right now. So you should have 10 of them. I'm going to pick up the homework real quick so I don't get that confused with the bell work. Make sure it's all open and neat, because neatness will matter. Make sure your name's on it, staple it, and then pass it to the left. I do not want it torn out. If you give me those torn out pages, I'm not going to look at them. So get that edge off. Okay, until I give you your worksheet back, I want area and I want arc length. And this is the back side, so do that for each one, and then let me get your homework in and I'll give it back to you. Yeah, pass it to the left and I'll get them in a minute. Just use a separate sheet of paper till I give you your stuff back. Yeah.
Can I have one
since I'll text? Yep, Hey guys, I'm going to take points off. I want my math work now. Come on, Jacqueline, come on. I want you to do both of them for each one. I'm almost done. Bless you. Okay, let me show you now. Hate to keep using Alyssa's. I got other ones here, but notice how she did her work. She did both of them, and she even labeled what it is. Area of sector and arc length. Really nice work, okay? So make sure that to get full credit that you do the same thing. Okay, and I got other ones that are really nice as well. All right, so let me get these back. Take your paper and then pass it around until everybody gets there. Okay, no name on this one. I can give you some credit, but I don't know who it is. Nobody wants to claim it? Is it yours? Thank you. Worksheet. Yep. Thank you. Yeah. Find something to do quietly. Gavin, any bell work at all? I mean, anything you turn in will help your cause. Sign up.
can answer the bathroom.
Sure.
Thank you.
Joe, have a seat and wait for that bell.
Like certain set of problems you had to round, and I like forgot to round them, so could you just maybe look at them?
Yeah, I will.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay. And it is tomorrow. Oh. Watch him out. Oh.
Sarah, are you supposed to be taking a test?
Yeah.
Oh. I'm supposed to take a what?
Do you have some work to give me, Thomas?
What work?
I just have my
You're supposed to do your work. Come here, Sarah. Which one you need, Thomas?
The box and whisker, but what work are you talking about?
Don't worry about it at this point. Sarah, do this side first. Okay, answer those questions.
Yes.
Only those. And then flip it over and do the back side. Okay, anyone else? Last call.
Thanks.
All right, right now I need you working only on this work right here. Can you factor it? What? You're testing, dear. That's okay. See Megan. Ron. Okay, I need you to factor. Put a question mark by the ones you need help with. Remember, what's in common? Always. If they have something in common, you must take it out first. It's not a question of will I take it out. You have to take it out. Yes, ma'am.
Did I miss it today?
We did part 6 on that packet.
we skipped the part six.
We skipped it?
No, we skipped over to it.
Oh.
I think we skipped four and five. You must know how to factor whether or not you need the PERT test or you don't need the PERT test. Now, tomorrow and Friday, I'm going to give you a new packet for those of you who did not pass the PERT test. And over the break, you need to complete that packet for credit. That's going to help you get ready for your test anyhow. The videos are posted from when I went over it. It's like 10 or 11 videos. When you click that button on Tuesday, you get back from break, you want to feel good about it. You want to pass. And if everybody makes it through, then every Friday we're going to relax and watch a little movie. But if one person does not pass that first test, we're going to be working. Because I can't justify giving you a break unless everybody does pass. Two more minutes. All right, let's take a look at the factoring now. I need you to pay attention.